sitting on top of a mountain. Who said that? Mountain. Somebody said, yes, right? Mountain with the water behind him. It's a peaceful scene, right? Effie kind of noticed that. Like, there's something very meditative about it, okay? He's surrounded, actually, by his heirs and other members of his court. And everyone is wearing a leopard pelt. So just keep that in the back of your mind. Try and figure out what that is all about and what that has to do with the idea of nature. Okay? Don't have to answer that just yet. So with all the colors and the textures that are in there.
Wait, you was there at the beginning of time? Or at least I thought you were?
Okay, so he's sitting amidst the flowers and an assortment of animals, predator and prey, right? Coexisting. Everything is about like how humans are coexisting with nature.
I like that.
Even predator and prey coexist together. And so the effect of the whole thing together, right, is about, it's depicting utopia. And like Kiba asked this great question, right? You know, plant life is kind of bursting into the margins of the people. Okay? It's a very lush scene. Yes.
Islam, Judaism, and Christianity, they all sort of stem from like around the same thing. So like they also believe that at the beginning when people were first created that we were perfect and that we were in like peace with nature.
Oh, great.
What? Oh, okay. I just had a question. Oh, wait. So if they're in peace with nature, then why are they wearing the leopard pelt? Because that's kind of rude. They just killed them. Right? And the first people I thought were like vegan or something.
So living in harmony, okay, but
like they also believe in like using every part of the animal. So attacking them, I guess.
Yeah.
Then they would make peace.
Yeah. Living in harmony and very peaceful, but you know, also having control. Right?
Oh yeah.
He also has control of the situation. Right?
Yeah.
Okay, so yes, peaceful, we all get along, but I'm the one that's in charge of everything, right? Yeah. Right?
That sounds like the human race summed up. We all live in harmony with nature, but we also still control it.
Yeah, we live in harmony, but we destroy it, and we're not taking care of it, and, you know, it's from our perspective.
Yeah,
right?
It's so funny.
Yeah, that's interesting.
Now this way, at 19, we have 11 years until it's irreversible.
11 years. 11 years. I love how we're doing the countdown in this class.
The countdown.
11 years till what?
Climate change.
World ends. The world
kills.
Yeah, pretty much.
Oh, I love that.
We predicted when the world is going to end. Jada and then here, and then we're going to break for pizza, and then head into the museum, okay? Yeah.
That's not like really stupid, but his...
Nothing ever is.
His cat, like, it kind of looks like it's
still... Oh!
And that's like the thing that he's seen that.
Yes! Oh my goodness. Yes.
That sounds silly.
Yeah, no. Do you guys see
yeah,
that?
Yeah, I get that, yeah.
Absolutely. Right? Yes. Just just want to all turn around and welcome our guests that are here tonight. And thank you so much for coming. So what we're going to do is we're going to kind of give a brief schedule of what we're going to do when we have our pizza. And these guys have been asked to kind of introduce themselves to you and come tonight, and they can talk about the class and, you know, answer any questions that you have. So essentially, you're kidding. Outside there in our little area, and you guys can introduce yourselves to our guests, and then we're going to kind of all come back in here. We're going to grab some materials, we'll go into the museum. All right, we're going to have two break-off sessions of VTS, and Alex is going to lead one discussion, which we are so excited for. All right, there have been 4 people in the class that have volunteered to kind of like practice VTS. And you guys are going to give her a little bit of feedback as to how she did with her facilitation. And we have like a form that you guys can use for that. You can also participate in the VTS conversation by taking some notes. And I'll explain this again in the museum. It will be a lot clearer when we have all our supplies in there. But just to give you a brief overview. And then what we're going to do is we're going to kind of spread out all of our Islamic works, right? This is the same thing that we did in the Greek and Roman gallery, right? Where you, with a partner, picked up an Islamic work, okay? And then you try to kind of make a connection and match that to either the works that we're going to view in the gallery or a global contemporary piece. Thumbs up if you remember when we did this in the Greek and Roman gallery. Okay, you tried to find a thematic connection, okay? But what we're gonna do that's a little different tonight, we're gonna extend that, and you're gonna have to come up with a 30-minute question. We've kind of seen the 30-minute question, we know what that looks like.
Do we have to answer?
No, okay? We're gonna use our elaboration skills, okay, to make a connection to another work and then pose a question, all right? And what we'll do in the museum is I will explain this kind of step by step. This is a lot of instructions up front, but it's just to give you an idea of what's going to happen, okay? And then we'll come back in to this space, all right? And hopefully we'll have some time to take a look at a couple of those questions. And at least 3 or 4 of those questions are going to appear on your take-home. Okay? All right? So those will be the questions that you will be able to select from when you go home and you do your Islamic take-home. Okay? So it's a lot of information up front, but we'll break it down step by step. So now we can go out, and you guys can help yourself to pizza. Please, again, introduce yourselves to our guests.
I thought it was expensive. I was like,